everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and yesterday Apple released watchOS 7 Developer Beta 2. This is available to all watchOS 7 supported devices if you're on the developer beta, so that means a Series 3, Series 4, and Series 5 Apple Watch. Now, this particular update came in at 299 megabytes on my Series 4 Apple Watch, and there's not really a ton new. So let's go over what is new, though. The first thing is Apple has been working hard on all of their different updates. And so the first thing is there's still 15 known issues, which is pretty typical of an early beta, but there's also 16 resolved issues. And some of those include scrolling fixed with the digital crown when there's no results shown, auto lock setup now works. Also, sharing a watch face, the send button now works properly. So if you wanted to share this watch face, hit the little share button there. And maybe you want to share this one, create a message, and then go ahead and share it. Before, it just would hang and wouldn't work properly all of the time. That should be resolved, among many other things. Now, as far as features that you can physically see, well, there's not a lot. In fact, it's really only specific to Chronograph Pro that I could find where there's any changes whatsoever. So if we go ahead and edit this watch face, they've updated the colors with basically everything new with all the new watch bands and also cases for your iPhone. So if you have one of the new matching iPhone cases, you can change the color to whatever you want. So you can see everything from cactus green, azure blue, or azure kind of blue. You've got Alaskan blue and then denim blue. And we can just go through all sorts of different colors that we have here. Everything from blue to gray to red to white to cocoa, as you can see there. Coastal gray is a new watch band. So you can match all of those new watch bands if that's what you want to do. So they've updated that. And that's it as far as physical updates in this particular version. Now, as far as things I'm not really fond of with watchOS 7, dismissing notifications is a little bit frustrating. You can't force press anymore. You need to go all the way to the top, clear all, and then you can dismiss your notifications. For some reason, you can't force press. That seems to me like there's going to be an updated Apple Watch, and maybe it won't have the force press layer. So maybe we won't be able to do that. But my friend Steve Mosier actually found a glyph or an image in iOS 14 beta 2 that shows an Apple Watch that's missing the little button here on the side. It still has the digital crown, as you can see, but there's no button. So maybe Apple is getting rid of that force press layer. They got rid of 3D touch on the iPhones. I guess that makes sense, but they still could sense when you're pressing on a notification longer. I would think they should bring that back, but maybe not. Now, other than that, there's not really anything new. However, everything does seem to be much faster. You'll see the watch apps are loading very quick, scrolling's nice and fast, and hopefully battery life is a little bit better. It wasn't really that great before, and I actually charged this morning, but I don't think it charged fully. So you do get those notifications now when your watch is fully charged on your iPhone, so that's really nice. But other than that, there's not really anything new in this beta. So everything should be working really well. It's faster. Battery life seems to be the same, at least this morning, but it's hard to say without using it for a few days. But in general, that's all they've changed in this. So a bunch of bug fixes and a few new colors. Now, let me know if you found anything else new in the comments below. Also, last time they added that battery health feature, and since I've been using it, let's go back here to settings. There we go. And that battery health feature is nice that we have an actual graph showing what's going on and battery health here. So my battery health is at 87%. So hopefully it will be, I guess that's what it will be. You can't really replace the battery in this. So I'll probably end up getting a Series 6 when that comes out. But let me know if you found anything else new in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on a new wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.